Welcome back for the studies of Lucy Poems by William Wordsworth. In this episode of the poem, we are going to study the thematic apperception of the text. We will be dealing with the first poem of the Lucy Poems, titled Strange Fits of Passion Have I Known. The Lucy Poems by William Wordsworth are found in the Lyrical Ballads, published by William Wordsworth and Coleridge together. And you may find five such poems which is dedicated to the Lucy, the character, the imaginary world of William Wordsworth. The five poems that you can find in the collection of poetry of William Wordsworth are Strange Fits of Passion Have I Known, She Dwelt Among the Untrodden Ways, I Traveled Among Unknown Men, 3 years she grew in sun and shower, A Slumber Did My Spirit Seal. Now, of these five poems, I shall be taking up the first one today for discussion. As we have already gone through the form and the structure of the poem, now without any delay, let's go through the thematic apperception of the first one. The first stanza of the poem that begins with the line, Strange fits of passion have I known, continues to say that I will dare to tell but in the lover's ear alone what once to me befell. Now, in this first stanza, it is not clear whether the lover he is referring to is Lucy herself, or is there someone else, or so on and so forth. Well, what he is presenting here is that he is going to tell whatever the strange fits of passion that he knows, which once to him befell, only in the ears of his lover. So he is choosing his audience, he is having something very intense to explain, and he cannot but explain it. So with such a dramatic opening, with a mysterious opening, the poem is presented to the audience. When we proceed further to the second stanza, there is this pronoun used, she, being used, which is indicative of a particular person he is referring to. When she I loved looked every day fresh as a rose in June. This is a metaphoric presentation of the green, the freshness of a person compared to the rose, a beautiful flower available. And that comparison is made to the girl. And I to her cottage bent my way. The very surprising and mysterious word is bent here. The going is now not a very straight line. It is bending. It is with a deliberate, with the effortful attempt of taking one's process or progression towards that point beneath the evening moon. Evening moon is a kind of a representation to the idea of either it is evening or evening of moon. Now, if you look into the idea of evening, evening is actually the time of the rising of the sun. It is not the setting of the sun. Actually, the setting of the sun is in the morning, isn't it? Now, if it is in the mornings or the journey of the sun, then evening is setting of the sun. But morning is the raising of the sun. For the moon, it is the raising of the moon. So there is something that is to begin from the point of view of the moon. We need the evening moon. But if you say the evening of the moon, and if you apply the idea of evening to the moon, then all sets of mysterious ideas pop into the understanding. So it leads to a plethora of voices that lead from here onwards. For what kind of a situation are we leading to? To which he is bending his way to the cottage of her. Third stanza keeps the same image of the moon as a standard point of reference. Upon the moon I fixed my eye, all over the wide lea, with quickening pace my horse drew nigh, those paths so dear to me. So this tells two very important things. One, the path with which he is traveling is a very well known path to him. It is not only familiar, it is also very dear to him. There is a second point that is mentioned here is that of he's not traveling all alone. He is riding a horse. So horse is also becoming a character in the narration of the text. So the pace in which the horse travels here also gives a reader an idea of the process or the progress of the ideas of the poet in explaining the Lucy poem. Fourth stanza tells us, and now we reached the orchard plot. So now these are certain locations he wants to, referential points of his journey, orchard plot for that matter, climbing the hill for that matter, and then Lucy's cottage. So before he reaches the Lucy's cot, he has to travel the orchard plot, he has to travel the hill. You know, the journey is not that easy as you can think of. It's not bed of roses. It is a very hazardous thing. So it is a deliberate journey that he takes on. Now, why does he take that journey? Because it is very dear to him. There is no question of not going the way. Now, he reached, he traveled, he climbed, and at the same time, there is a kind of reference to the sinking moon. The next stanza, the fifth stanza, giving a very different look altogether. It just turns the table. It just puts you onto a different course altogether. In one of those sweet dreams I slept. You remember? When Wordsworth was explaining his theory of poetry, he was saying that poetry is a spontaneous overflow of powerful feelings. You know, the continuation of that particular expression also said, recollected in tranquility. So there is a spontaneous overflow of powerful feelings, but the poetry is recollect, all these powerful feelings are recollected in tranquility. Now the text is presenting to you some such recollection that takes place. So kind nature's gentle boom. So he's also saying nature with N capital, and he says this recollection, this sweet dream is the gentlest boon by the nature. And all the while my eyes I kept upon the descending moon. These images flash on his mind, keeping this image of the descending moon in his mind. The image of the horse comes back in the sixth stanza, wherein says, my horse moved on, hoof after hoof. Now it is not he is traveling. The horse knows the way. Horse takes him all ahead. He raced and never stopped. He knows his destination. So it is not the journey or the travel that the narrator is doing anymore. It is being now taken away by the horse itself. When down behind the cottage roof at once, the bright moon dropped. So as soon as he reached the place, it is also the setting of the moon. The final stanza of the poem presents to us some strange fits of passion. The first line of the stanza, the same thing comes back. What fond and wavered thoughts will slide. Look at the strange fits of passion, the first line. Fond and wavered thoughts in the first line of the last stanza. To a lover's head. See, he said, I can tell it only to the ears of the lover in the first stanza. Now it came to the lover's head. What he says is, to himself he cried. What did he say? What did he cry? Oh mercy, if Lucy should be dead. All at once, at that point of the time, he just has a strange feeling after doing this whole journey, when he really reached that point, is it too late? So that's what the text is presenting as a kind of a shock with which the text is coming to an end. This is a broad understanding of the text. Let us discuss in detail about this poem when we meet in the class. Thank you so much.